Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Respected and revered brothers engaged in the effort of da'wat, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We hope that you must be doing well and would be enriching and flourishing the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and must be completely engrossed with the effort of nourishing it. May Allah accept and may He make it possible to make your efforts a mean of hidayat for the entire world. My dear friends, the most basic and appreciable effort and crucial aspect as well as the mainstay or linchpin of deen is the movement in the path of Allah. Deen in its entirety along with its collective and specific attribute has spread in the world due to the movement of its followers. This is the reason that the first Khalifa, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anh, upon learning that a few individuals were refusing to comply with regard to one portion of deen, had stated that if anyone who was providing the cattle rope along with the animal during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as part of their zakat dues discontinues to do so, then I will fight with them. At this juncture, Abu Bakr radiallahu anh was prepared to dispatch all the people of Madinah Munawwara, including himself, on this mission, and if a situation were to arise in their absence wherein the sacred wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were to pass away while there was no one left behind to take care of the funeral and bury them, even then Madinah would be emptied. As a matter of fact, he uttered even more severe words on this occasion. At this point, it is for me and all of us to ponder that a reaction to the denial of handling over one rope, they were prepared to evacuate entire Madinah Munawwara. In our case, however, even a rope's worth of deen is not present in the Ummah today. In such conditions, doesn't the significance and urgency of Khuruj become exponentially much more crucial? Hazrat Maulana Ilyas Rahmatullahi Alayh used to say that delay in proceeding in the path of Allah is an open invitation to the warth of Allah. Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullahi Alayh would say that the more going out in path of Allah become prevalent, that much more the doors of Allah's chastisement will close and doors of peace and tranquility, nusrat and success will open up. On one side are one's own personal needs and necessities, and on the other side is the deplorable state of the ummah. Whosoever does not consider the conditions of the ummah greater than one's own condition, then he cannot be representative of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam or even a da'i for that matter. If our fellow companions and those in field of the effort, especially those who are senior responsible workers, do not have a Siddiqui temperament, then our work and its direction will change course. We are waiting for conditions to become conducive for doing the effort, while Allah is waiting for our efforts and assistance of deen from our end in order to make the conditions conducive. In countries where, to whatever extent possible, there is scope of making the effort of da'wat, and despite that, if it is not done, then an atrocious act of being thankless towards Allah's blessing is being done. Additionally, this negligence is a means of blocking further avenue from opening up, and thanklessness lead to calamity and withdrawal of blessings. May Allah save us. Jamaats for 4 months, 40 days, and jamaats for fulfilling overseas taqazas should be made. For whichever country jamaat are decided, inshaAllah, Allah will ease the pathway to those countries. When those who had the concern and zeal and desire for establishment of deen, like the Anbiya alayhi salam, travelled in the path of Allah, Allah made it possible for them to gallop across oceans. Those who go out with similar aspirations and desire, why will then Allah not make arrangements of transportation for them? Consequently, you must keep in view the taqazas of your entire country and implement the following tartib as outlined below. With due regard to the preventive health guidelines laid down by authorities in your country, make mashwara to gather old workers in one or two or as appropriate locations. Ensure that the chosen location is feasible and convenient to gather the old workers of the country. From such gatherings, small jamaats of more or less 2 or 3 brothers each should be formed and dispatched to make effort in various areas of your entire country. The objective of these jamaat is to gather the responsible brothers of different region and give them targheeb and encouragement to take responsibility for further making small jamaats that would make effort door to door and talk to individual in their cities, towns, villages in order to increase the a'mal of da'wat and khuruj of individuals, giving them fazail for proceeding in the path of Allah and explaining to them the importance of making effort in these conditions. Movement should be made in every locality, making effort to establish the a'mal of da'wat and populating the masajid with 24 hours nabawi a'mal. In localities where masajids are open only for salah, brothers may make mashwara and decide upon alternate places for making efforts while conducting the amal of masjid in those places, ensuring the fikr and physical effort is made to connect each individual of this ummah with these amal. Masajids are a place of hidayat and the amal therein are amal of hidayat. Without masajids and these amal, it is neither possible for the ummah to remain on hidayat nor be recipient of any khair. These jamaats should keep the khazas of the work in front of them and present their karguzari upon their return. A great benefit of this movement is that the responsible old workers and the brothers of shura of the country will themselves be able to witness firsthand the plight of the work. In every condition, for the help and nusrat of Allah to descend, a basic requirement is that the responsible brother should themselves come down and make effort in the field. In the battle of Khandaq, to break a stubborn rock, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself said that he would descend in the trench. Therefore, the one with strong iman become victorious, and news of several monumental victories and glad tidings were given for what was to come in the future. Allah manifested these events with his unseen system against the apparent. Maulana Yusuf rahmatullahi alaihi used to say that in times of crucial conditions, to the extent the foremost and primary workers become active, to that extent the work will penetrate and avenues will open for reception and welcoming of the work amongst the common people. We are hopeful that at this time your movement in the country will be a great means of encouragement and of tremendous help for the brothers and will result in bringing the work back on its course, insha'Allah. Keep making efforts as per guidelines already provided and send us your karguzaris. May Allah provide us courage and may He accept our efforts through His mercy. Ameen. Wassalam, Maulana Saad and elders of the Banglewali Masjid, Basti Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, New Delhi.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Shubhat ka izala page ko subscribe karein aur bell icon dabayein.